Hi, I'm Paula Moore, the chiropractor, presenting Forward Head Posture, The Shocking Truth, in a three-part series. Today, looking at part one, how your neck should really look. We'll look at what normal alignment really is. In part two, I'm going to show you my own x-rays and my mother's x-rays and show you how you can predict how your posture may end up just by looking at your own family. Part three, we'll look at some x-rays of a 60-year-old patient who has had devastating effects from having forward head posture never corrected. So it's going to be a very interesting series. Let's start here today with normal, or the ideal posture. So here we have an individual's x-rays looking sideways on. Just to orient you, you can see here we've got the chin of the individual. You can see this person's not young. You can just take a look at the teeth, just to give you an idea that elderly people, middle-aged people can also have ideal, good-looking posture when they take care of it. Here is the skull bone, the back of the head. And then we've got seven vertebrae in the neck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. C is for cervical, the cervical spine. Now I'm going to draw in a couple of lines here to show you this person's alignment. Okay. And let me choose another color here. I'm going to draw some lines down the axis of the vertebra to show you what a neck curve should look like. So that's the backs of the vertebra here. And what you'll start to see is we get a really nice C-shaped curve. This is called the lordosis. And we should have one in the neck and one in the low back, a gentle curving in. And if I were to extend the curves, you would see that in a normal individual, the red curve should intersect this vertical line so that you end up with the ears directly over top of the shoulder. That would be ideal posture. That's the ideal head positioning. And with that ideal posture, the neck is at a mechanical advantage. It's not overworking. So you can see we've got lovely, healthy disc spaces here between the bones, between the vertebrae. Good cartilage cushions all the way along. And we've got really healthy neck joints, these little black slivers here. That space shows us that there's still good cartilage left between there. And overall, you'll notice really good white quality bones. Not looking like light gray like the muscle tissue in the back of the neck, but good quality bone. Should have lots of calcium. It should be a nice white color. So here we have how your neck should really look. So join me now for part two at posturevideos.com, and we'll look at what can happen in families when postures are left uncorrected. Okay, thanks for watching.